Moving on, a World Bank official held a briefing while in Manila earlier today. Andrea Taguines is on the line for the details. Hi, Andy. So what did he say?
Good afternoon, Mimi. The World Bank on Tuesday said it expects inflation in the Philippines to fall within the government's 2-4% target range next year after the November data showed the inflation rate further easing to 4.1%. He particularly, senior World Bank economist Ralph Bourne-Doon, particularly noted that it was good to see both food inflation and non-food inflation decreasing. And as price pressures cool, Van Zuren believes the economy could get a stronger boost from household consumption this holiday season and up to 2024. The World Bank sees the Philippines' gross domestic product growing by an average of 5.8% in 2024, higher than its 5.6% growth projection for the whole of 2023. But Van Zuren also cited various risks that could again trigger higher food and energy prices, such as escalating geopolitical tensions, trade restrictions on agricultural products, as well as domestically, El Nino and other weather disturbances. To mitigate these risks, the World Bank urged the Philippine government to continue with its strategy of using both monetary and non-monetary measures to increase supply of imports, lower the tariffs of key commodities, and assure better supply and demand management for food items. The World Bank also highlighted the need for more pro-investment reforms and their speedy implementation to stimulate the economic growth in the medium term. That's as Van Zuren noted that the Philippines is still lagging compared to its neighbors in terms of investments. Van Zuren also put a premium on the kind of investments that will not only increase the Philippines' capital stock, but would also lead to greater productivity. As an example, he cited how the Public Services Act can create more competition in key public service sectors and increase the quality of the service delivered, benefiting sectors such as manufacturing. Mimi?
Right. On that note, thank you very much, Andy, for the update. TELUS International Philippines utilizing the power of artificial intelligence in its customer service call center without displacing human labor. TELUS Philippines Vice President Ann Munoz says the company has embraced AI technology to be able to enhance its productivity and customer experience. It has seen impactful results in terms of speed to proficiency.
Our team leaders being augmented with an actual bot to help them with administrative tasks so that they can focus on coaching our team members. Second is an agent assist bot. It is actually working hand in hand with our team members, you know, solving customers' problems real time. The approach is humanity in the loop, where our team members are focusing on the connection and the conversation, while the agent bot is assisting them on providing them real-time accurate responses and solutions for our customers.
Consul Yunina Manjo is the new head of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Manjo, who owns several large businesses, was unanimously elected by the PCCI's Board of Directors last Friday. She is the third woman president of the prestigious business organization. Manjo is also an honorary consul of the Republic of Liberia in West Africa. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. reiterates his call for the Philippines to host the Loss and Damage Fund to ensure the needs of countries ravaged by the effects of climate change will be addressed. Marcos's pitch was delivered by Environment Secretary Tony Yulo Loizaga during the COP28 summit in Dubai. Loizaga adds the Philippines is also vying for a seat in the Loss and Damage Fund board. Marcos also said it's imperative for COP28 to sufficiently inform parties in enhancing climate actions and international cooperation based on equity and climate justice. You're still on the business roadshow. The Philippine trade industry sees aerospace exports getting a boost from the comprehensive economic partnership agreement between Manila and Abu Dhabi. DTI Undersecretary Alan Gepti said the possible free trade deal will benefit high-value export products of the Philippines, especially parts of helicopters and aircraft, which had the highest annual export growth in 2022. He adds that aside from the aerospace sector, the agreement could also boost Philippine exports of agricultural and industrial to the Middle East, as well as Europe, with the UAE serving as a hub. The Trade Department said the Philippines hopes to finish free trade talks with UAE within 2 years.